Hello everyone. Today I'd like to explain one of the most important discoveries for our daily life. Electromagnetic inductions. We could convert different form of the energy into the electric energies. So this was discovered by genius scientist Michael Faraday. Electromagnetic induction, epsilon, is equal to the minus N times the derivative of C sub B is a magnetic flux with respect to T. Epsilon is an induced EMF, and N is the number of turns, so N turns of coils we consider. So this is a Faraday's laws. So if the magnetic flux is increasing, then EMF is induced in a negative direction with respect to the magnetic flux. So I'd like to show that this equation by making a simple experiment. So I have two wires. One of the wire is a short wires with the red ones, and the other one is a wires of the combination of red wires and white wires. And the white wires and the red wire has the same length. So compared with the first ones, red and the white wire has a length of the twice longer than the red wires. So I use short red wires to make a coils. I'm gonna connect the wires with the digital multimeters. So I connect the digital multimeters with the coils. I'm gonna drop this magnet into the tube. Then magnetic flux through that coil is increasing because the magnet is approaching this coil. We'd like to measure the induced EMF. So now it's zero. So let's see. So you can find that the negative 2.2 or 3. So I'd like to show the one more times. So it becomes negative 2.9. So one more times. Negative 2.4. Okay, so about the 2.5 millivolt if we use the single wires. When the magnet doesn't move, induced EMF becomes a zero. So the induced EMF due to the motions of the magnet with respect to the wires. Now we'd like to increase the number of turns of the coils. Now the coil has twice longer than the previous ones. I use wires made of the red and the white wires. So length becomes twice. Now coil has N twice. We expect the induced EMF becomes twice. So I drop a magnet to the coils. You can read the numbers in the digital multimeters. 5.2, 4.8, 5.1. In this experiment, we could confirm the Faraday's laws. I use two coils. One of the coil is made of only the red wires. And the second experiment, I use red and white wires. So length becomes twice. So because of the different lengths, actually number of turns of the N becomes increasing by twice. Compared with the first case, second case, induced EMF becomes twice. Because the first case, average value of the induced EMF is 2.5. In the second case, number of turns of the coil becomes twice. Induced EMF becomes about 5 millivolt. We could confirm the Faraday's laws with this simple experiment.